Maybe we could all go out and celebrate after the mission. Tea? No?
Okay. Let's keep this up for our next mission, too.
Nice work out there, as always. Now come back so I can see your smiling faces.
I'll tackle this one. Nice work out there, Captain. I can't believe it's only your first year, too. Not only did you get raised to captain of the Special Forces, but even when you pitch in with the other squads, you're still the ringer. Deep into my first year, I was struggling to go toe-to-toe with an ogre tail. This is my 12th year as a God Eater. Wow, I am old. I don't like to be that guy, but I think I've done well to come this far. To be honest, my compatibility rating with God Arcs is actually pretty low. Like, dismally low. It was rough for a while. This giant thing just wouldn't listen to a damn word I said, no matter what I said. In fact, I think my first instructor actually looked me in the eyes once and told me that I was the worst he'd ever seen. But I wouldn't give up. I practiced at nights and on off days, and I sweat and finally started, you know, actually helping. At the same time, there's Canna. She's got an incredible, amazing compatibility rating. She's a prodigy, but she's not a great shot. Still, the day after she passed her test, her God Arc was like a part of her, like she was born with it in her hand. I was pretty jealous of her for a long time, but in the end, I guess you've either got it or you don't. But once you've been a God Eater for a while, once you've seen what you can do, none of that petty stuff matters anymore. You just gotta play well with the cards you're dealt. And I feel like I got a pretty solid set of cards. Who knows, maybe one day I'll wake up and my God Arc will just be done with me. Even then, even if I couldn't be a God Eater anymore, I still want to protect everyone in the ghettos, in the frontier. Sorry about that. I guess I just started rambling and couldn't stop myself. The transport unit should be here to pick us up soon. We'd better head back.